The Duchess of Cambridge is launching a personal crusade to highlight the importance of children's mental health as teenage suicides in Britain hit a 35-year high. Tomorrow Kate will visit schools with the charity Place to Be that provides in-school support and counseling to students. Her intervention came after the grieving father of 14-year-old Molly Russell accused Instagram of helping to kill her after the schoolgirl took her own life. The teenage suicide rate has almost doubled in 8 years, it emerged yesterday, as ministers vowed to crack down on the internet giants accused of fueling youngsters' distress. A palace source told The Mirror, "She is passionate about children and their well-being, and this focus has already been shown to be a huge part of what she sees as her work." The Duchess believes the mental health of children and young people is one of the big challenges of our time. The younger royals are crusading to banish the stigma of mental health problems among teenagers and young adults. Her husband William and brother-in-law Harry have spoken about the devastation when their mother died caused as part of the Heads Together campaign started almost 3 years ago. William said he struggled and needed help after starting as an air ambulance pilot. He said, "If I hadn't taken the action I did, I would have gone down a slippery slope and been dealing with mental illness on a different level." Harry said that without help to cope with the loss of his mother, he said, "I have probably percent of been close to a breakdown on numerous occasions." Kate's own brother James Middleton, 31, has admitted he has battled depression. The Duchess believes the right support, from birth, can help disadvantaged youngsters reach their potential. She is bringing together experts from academia, education, health and other fields to work on how to help families tackle antisocial behavior, addiction and mental health. The subject is politically fraught, with some blaming broken Britain on parents and others blaming budget cuts. But sources say the 36-year-old Duchess is determined to push ahead because she sees it as potentially as big an issue as climate change. "This is a lifelong project," said one royal source. She is looking at what she can do over the next 5, 10, 15, 20 years. She wants to be able to look back and see what difference has been made. That's what her position in public life allows her to do. New figures show the rate among children aged between 15 and 19 has risen, despite falling for most other age groups. The Provisional Office for National Statistics data for last year reveal that suicides are running at more than 5 in 100,000 among teenagers in England. In 2010, the rate was just over 3 in 100,000. Ian Russell, 55, of Harrow, Northwest London, said his daughter Molly had gone to bed in a good mood but decided to kill herself after looking at troubling images that night. He added, "I have no doubt that Instagram helped kill my daughter." Education Secretary Damian Hines yesterday said social media firms had a moral duty to act on harmful images hosted by their sites. Pilot schemes to boost mental health will be launched in schools today, and Dame Sally Davis, the chief medical officer, will announce her findings that teenage suicides are linked with self-harm and spending more than 4 hours a day on social media apps. She will tell technology giants such as Facebook, Instagram and Snapchat that they have a duty of care, clearing the way for a new regulator to press the firms to remove the worst material. And she will call on parents to ban smartphones from the dinner table and before bedtime, and limit screen time to 2 hours at a time. Professor Louis Appleby, head of the National Suicide Prevention Strategy, told the Sunday Times, "The danger is that we are presiding over a suicidal generation of young people and that young people have learned self-harm as a way of coping." He said 1 in 4 teenage girls and 1 in 10 boys were self-harming. Ministers will publish a white paper at the end of the month setting out new demands for social media firms to protect young people. Online firms will be ordered to shield their users from images of suicide, self-harm and bullying and told to remove references to suicide and self-harm methods. Tech giants will have to sign up to new corporate social responsibility standards that will require them to remove material quickly and comprehensively. They will also face a new duty to set out how many complaints of online bullying, self-harm, trolling, rape and other threats they have received. If they refuse, or act too slowly, a new regulator will step in. Professor Appleby's three-year study into hundreds of youngsters who killed themselves found that a quarter had used the internet in a way that was suicide-related and 1 in 25 had visited websites where suicide was encouraged. He warned that government thinking lagged behind the reality of how teenagers were using social media. "We have been looking at how much screen time youngsters have, which is a crude measure," he said. "It does not tell you anything about how young people are using screens." Professor Appleby said parents should worry less about children spending time on phones and more about what they were doing online. "One worrying example would be if they are sending each other self-harm images," he said. "That runs the risk of self-harm spreading as a kind of contagion. We should be worried about Instagram and the images that people pass to each other." TV presenter Esther Ranson, who set up the Childline charity, said her own research linked the rise in suicide and self-harm to children's use of the internet and social media. She added, "I am very concerned about the calls we are receiving. So many of them talk about being suicidal. I am seeing a huge rise in unhappiness among our children, and when I talk to our counselors up and down the country and ask them why, they always say social media. Young people are looking for comfort on the internet where there are people who feel the way they do. Tragically, they are finding them in the solutions they are offering are coping mechanisms which are self-harm, even to the point of suicide." Facebook and Instagram said, "We have a deep responsibility to make sure people on Instagram and Facebook are safe. We do not allow content that promotes or encourages suicide or self-injury, and we will remove it as soon as we are aware. We have started a full review of our policies, enforcement and technologies around suicide and self-injury content. While we conduct this review, over the past week we have had a team of engineers working round the clock to make changes to make it harder for people to search for and find self-harm content." Google said, "When people in need turn to the internet for advice and search for queries relating to suicide, we show the Samaritan's 24-hour helpline number to connect people who are depressed, suicidal or in distress with the help and advice they need."